Hey, another temporary setup and probably few more are coming. Nevertheless, for those that were criticizing my microphone, I have a good news. The new mic is on the way, and it's coming in blue. Afterwards, we're gonna deal with lightning. You know, Apple did fulfill the promise.
And we promised that the first Mac with Apple Silicon would arrive by the end of this year. Well, that day is here.
So far, the M1 Apple Silicon has exceeded our expectations. But many of us wanted more. Not in terms of power, though, because initially we were skeptics, but in terms of visual appearance and variety that would hopefully delight us with some new and exciting designs and, hell, new MacBook options. That did not take place. Even if Apple really went beyond in terms of releases in 2020, now it's time for 2021 and the wonders we should hope for. I have a weird question for you guys. Just plain brainstorming. If by some weird reason Apple decides to re-establish MacBooks with new lineups that consist from 12-inch MacBook Air, 14-inch MacBook, and 16-inch MacBook Pro, would that make sense for you? I'm curious. Please answer in the comment section below. Now the intro and let's go. Hi guys and welcome to Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco and this is your weekly fix of tech news, leaks, rumors and opinions, everything about Apple and their competitors. If you're a fan of this type of content, subscribe now, leave a comment below, hit the like button and don't forget to enable notifications so you don't miss the next video. Let's deal with the elephant in the room first, before you accuse me for clickbaiting. When Apple's 16-inch MacBook Pro arrived, it was already anticipated it will replace 15-inch version, and this move did make sense, maintaining not such a big form factor while making the display larger. That was an excellent decision. If Apple decides to include 14-inch MacBook Pro in his lineup, I wouldn't be surprised if it comes as a replacement for 13-inch model. That's what I think. The reason why I'm specific about 13-inch MacBook Pro and not about the Air is a cloud of doubt about potential return of 12-inch MacBook. Previous rumors went as far as completely eliminating the term Air from Apple's MacBook offer. We were expecting this 12-inch MacBook with 4th-generation Butterfly keyboard, but it seems like something did not go as planned, or maybe it was never true. Regardless, from 2021, I wouldn't be surprised if MacBook Air remains the only 13-inch MacBook, unless it really gets replaced by 12-inch model. Makes sense, don't you agree? Or it doesn't. What am I talking about? And listen, if we look back in 2020, we had so many rumors and predictions. Mini LED MacBooks, 14-inch redesign and probably new 16-inch model. The return of 12-inch MacBook. As we all know, none of it happened. That's why we're digging into 2021. The latest round of predictions is now specifically targeting at Apple Silicon and what could be its next iteration. Remember a few months ago when alleged leaked information suggested that the first Apple's chip will be a 12-core beast? Nope. I mean, there is a possibility, and I cannot say I wouldn't want it. It would be awesome. But here's the deal. Apple does not have to include any new version of processor next year, considering how impressive its current performance is. I know what you're gonna say. But just look at the differences between the base MacBook Air and MacBook Pro. Both powered by M1 processor. The first one is completely basic option with even one GPU locked, the other at its full potential, with extra cooler plus. Crazy, right? Before we move on, guys, if you like what you've seen so far, hit the thumbs up, leave a comment, and once again subscribe. It means a lot for the future of this channel, so thanks a lot. Now let's go back. So what would be the next improvement of the M1 chip? Again, I'm kind of skeptical about so-called M2 in 2021. I may be wrong, but there is absolutely no need to push beyond. And judging by the recent moves by Apple to slightly step A12X to A12Z processors from one iPad Pro generation to the next one, it could happen the same with the M1. However, it would be cool if Apple decide to use more unified memory for the upcoming models. So for example, for 14-inch MacBook Pro, they can give options between 16 and 32 gigs of memory. And they can go even more with the iMac or 16-inch MacBook Pro. For example, they can offer you options between 32 and 64 gigs of memory. This will absolutely differentiate models between each other without the need to push higher CPU frequencies. Not at all. Unless Apple is still keeping the M1 intentionally away from its full potential. Interesting to think, no? But do you know what's funny? Apple is the only manufacturer in the world that has such a simplified hardware selection process. It's almost insane. One chip with more or less unified memory, bigger or smaller display, regardless if it's LCD or mini LED, more or less storage. Come on, this is not even a gaming console. Kudos for that, Apple. That's it. As I've mentioned, the new mic is coming, and afterwards, studio lighting, eventually new camera. So stay tuned. I appreciate all your feedbacks and your time for watching my videos. Thank you for that. My name is Marco, and this is Digital Marketing Channel. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye.